Assalamu alaikum dear students. So this is my sixth video lecture on chapter number 9, that is current electricity. So inshallah, in this video lecture we will study regarding galvanometer and how to convert galvanometer into an ammeter and galvanometer as an voltmeter. This image of device is called as galvanometer. As we have already studied the use of galvanometer in meter bridge and Kelvin's method, you can see a pointer is at zero. This condition of galvanometer is called as balance condition and point is called as null point. There is a two knob, you can see the black one and the red one. These two knobs are used for electrical connection. Basically, galvanometer is a device used to detect a weak electric current. This is an internal structure of galvanometer. It has a coil pivoted or suspended between concave pole faces of a strong laminated horseshoe magnet, as you can see N pole and S pole. When an electric current passes through the coil, it deflects. The deflection is proportional to the current passing through the coil. The deflection of the coil can be read with the help of a pointer attached to it. Position of the pointer on the scale provided indicates the current passing through the galvanometer or potential difference across it. Thus, a galvanometer can be used as an ammeter or voltmeter with suitable modification. The galvanometer coil has a moderate resistance about 100 ohms and galvanometer itself has a small current carrying capacity about 1 milliampere. In the design of moving coil galvanometer, the spring of a moving coil are very delicate, hence give full scale deflection for a current of order of 10 milliampere that it can carry a maximum current of 10 milliampere. If current larger than this limiting value is sent through the coil of moving coil galvanometer, it can get damaged. So if we have to measure a current greater than 10 milliampere, so there must be some other device which can measure this amount of current. This device is nothing but called as ammeter. So let's study how to convert a galvanometer into an ammeter. Galvanometer can be converted into an ammeter, which is a current measuring instrument. So galvanometer is always connected in series with a resistance R through which current is to be measured. When larger current is to be measured, a low resistance is connected in parallel with moving coil galvanometer, which is called shunt. The instrument scale is calibrated to read directly total current. Such instrument used to measure current is called as an ammeter. Now this shunt resistance will bypass most of the current and allows smaller current to flow through the moving coil galvanometer. Now why we have connected shunt resistor in parallel with, what is the function of this shunt resistance? So shunt resistance reduces the effective resistance of an ammeter. It increases the range of instrument. It provides an alternate path for excess current to pass, which protects galvanometer from the damage. So this is how a galvanometer can be converted into an ammeter. Now let's consider G is the resistance of the galvanometer and the current across the galvanometer is flows, it is nothing but IG, and the current flows across the shunt resistance, it will be a IS, and I is the current which is to be measured. So finally here we are having total current, that is I, is nothing but IG plus IS. So consider this is as equation number 1. So if we have to find only IS, so IS is nothing but I minus IG. Now as we know that galvanometer and shunt resistance is connected parallelly, so potential difference across galvanometer is always equal to potential difference across shunt resistance. This is why, because shunt resistance is connected parallel to the galvanometer. So here, according to Ohm's law, that potential difference across G is equal to potential difference across shunt, that is S. Now why we are doing this? Because we have to find a low value resistance that we have connected parallel to the galvanometer. So we have to find the value for the low value resistance. So we have to derive the formula for the shunt, that is S. So potential difference across G, according to Ohm's law, is equal to IR. So as we know that G is the galvanometer's resistance and IG is the current across this galvanometer. So according to Ohm's law, GIG is equal to SIS. So we have to find only the formula for S. Now, as we know that IS is nothing but I minus IG, so we can substitute the value of IS here. So it will become GIG is equal to S I minus IG. So finally, S is nothing but IG upon I minus IG into G. So this is one of the formula to find the value of shunt resistance that we are going to connect across the galvanometer, and it is a low resistance. Now further, if the current I is n times the current of IG, so we can write this equation as S is nothing but IgG upon, instead of this I, we can write NIG minus IG. So finally, what we can have? We can have S is nothing but G upon N minus 1. So this is another formula to increase the range n times. So this both the formula is to find the value of shunt resistance, that low value resistance that is connected parallel with the galvanometer. Now you can see here, the current that is passes across the shunt resistance is nothing but IS. So you can also find the current across the shunt resistance. So for this, as we know that potential difference across galvanometer is equal to potential difference across shunt resistance, because both are parallelly connected to each other. So we can write that GIG, instead of this IG, we can write, see, as we know that I is nothing but IG plus IS, so according to equation number 1, we can have IG is nothing but I minus IS. So here GIG is equal to SIS, that means G, instead of this IG, we can write it is I minus I S is equal to S I S. Now open the bracket here. So it will be G I minus G I S is equal to S I S. Now keep I S at one side. So you will have here GI is nothing but S I S minus G I S. Now take I S common. I S is common, so remaining is what? It will be plus. S plus G. Fine. Now you can find the formula for the I S. So I S can be at their place only. The remaining term, that is G upon S plus G into I. So this is the third formula to find the current across the shunt resistance. Then you can also find the fraction of the total current through the shunt resistance, that is nothing but I S upon I. This I is equal to G upon S plus G. So this equation gives the fraction of total current through the shunt resistance. So these are the formulas. To find the shunt resistance, to find the current across the shunt resistance, to find the fraction of these currents. So this is how a galvanometer can be converted into an ammeter or galvanometer as an ammeter. You might have seen this instrument in your laboratory. This is nothing but voltmeter. A voltmeter is an instrument used to measure potential difference between two points in an electrical circuit. It is always connected in parallel with the component across which voltage drop is to be measured. As you can see, there is a two knob at the top of this instrument. Black is referred as negative terminal and red one is referred as positive terminal. Let's see how a galvanometer can be converted into a voltmeter. As we know that moving coil galvanometer is very delicate and can give full scale deflection for current when small potential difference is applied across its terminals. Hence, to measure large potential difference, effective resistance of instrument should be high. On other hand, if large potential difference is applied across the terminal of moving coil galvanometer, large current will pass through the coil of moving coil galvanometer, which may result in burning of coil due to excessive heat produced. The moving coil galvanometer will be protected from such probable damage if high resistance is connected in series with moving coil galvanometer. Connecting high resistance in series with galvanometer, its voltage measuring capacity will be increased to desired higher value. Now, as we have already studied in potentiometer that an ideal voltmeter has infinite resistance, so when it is connected between two points in a circuit would not change the value of current. So consider here, let IG be the current flowing through the galvanometer for which galvanometer gives full scale deflection. Let G be the resistance of galvanometer and X is the high resistance that we have connected in series with the galvanometer. V, capital V, is the voltage which is to be measured. So according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. So V is equal to I, the current is nothing but IG. And R, we are having two resistance. One is high value resistance, another is the resistance of galvanometer. So it will be here X plus G. Now why we are doing this? Because we have to find the formula for the X, that is the high resistance connected in series with galvanometer. So what should be the value of this higher resistance so that we can measure? So first we have to derive the formula for the X. So finally, X plus G is equal to V upon IG. So X will be at their place. V upon IG. This plus G will be have this side minus G. So this is the formula. First formula to calculate the value of high resistance that is connected in series with moving coil galvanometer, so that a galvanometer can be converted into an voltmeter. Secondly, if you are going to consider that the potential difference is nothing but n times of the potential difference across the potential difference generated across the galvanometer. So we can have x is nothing but this equation will become, instead of this V, we can write nVg upon Ig minus G. So x, Vg is the potential difference across the galvanometer. So according to Ohm's law, current is Ig and resistance is G. So N Ig upon Ig minus G. So Ig, Ig will cancel. X is equal to Ng minus G. That means X is nothing but G N minus 1. So this is the other formula to find high resistance that is connected in series with coil, moving coil galvanometer. Then you can also find resistance of potential difference. So how you are going to find the resistance of potential difference? Suppose the resistance of potential difference is nothing but R. See here, a voltmeter is connected across this resistance R. So the over resistance is nothing but X plus G. This resistance we have connected because we have to note down the volt across this resistance. So over resistance is nothing but X plus G. Now already we know that X itself is nothing but Ng minus G. So instead of this X, you can write Ng minus G plus G. This will be as it is. So plus G minus G will cancel. So resistance across the voltmeter is nothing but Ng. So this is the formula to find the resistance across the voltmeter. So these are the formulas, and by connecting a high resistance in series with galvanometer, a galvanometer can be converted into an voltmeter, or we can have a galvanometer as an voltmeter. So these are the formulas that we have derived while converting a galvanometer into an ammeter. So here, this is a formula for the shunt, that is the low resistance connected parallel with galvanometer, so that galvanometer can be converted into an ammeter. So this is the formula. This is the second formula to find the shunt, the value of the low resistance that we have connected. And these are the formula to find the current across the shunt. Now see, this formula is for X, that is the high resistance connected in series with the galvanometer, so that galvanometer can be converted into a voltmeter. So these are the two formulas to find the high value resistance that is connected in series with the moving coil galvanometer, and this is the formula to find the resistance of voltmeter. So these all formulas we will use in the numericals that is given in your textbook. So you have to remember these formulas. After study voltmeter and ammeter, let's discuss the comparison of both. Number one, ammeter is measure current while voltmeter is measure potential difference. This is very basic point. Number two, ammeter is connected in series while voltmeter is connected in parallel. Number three, ammeter is a moving coil galvanometer with low resistance, that is ideally zero, while voltmeter is a moving coil galvanometer with high resistance, ideally infinite. Number four, smaller the shunt, greater will be the current measure. While in voltmeter, larger its resistance, greater will be the potential difference. We can have one more point that while converting galvanometer into an ammeter, a low resistance is connected in parallel with the moving coil galvanometer, that is called shunt. In voltmeter, a high resistance is connected in series with moving coil galvanometer so that it can convert into a voltmeter. Then in the last point, you can have so many formulas because we have derived three formulas. So you can have the last point as a resistance of ammeter. The formula for the same is already you can see. Then you can have one more point, that is the formula for the S shunt, that low value resistance is connected parallel to the galvanometer so that it can convert into an ammeter. Then in voltmeter you can have the formula for X, that is high value resistance connected in series with moving coil galvanometer so that galvanometer can be converted into an ammeter. So these are the points that you can compare both ammeter and voltmeter. So inshallah on 23rd of May we will have our 7th video lecture, that will be the last video lecture on chapter number 9, that is current electricity. And in this video lecture inshallah we will discuss the application based question of potentiometer, voltmeter and ammeter. Thank you.